see across the way except for the fire of 93, which changed things a little bit. But when she first came to the property, she made a list of everything that was growing, and there were roughly 55 different plants that she could identify. By the time she stopped counting, there were 1,500. But it changed after each fire. She would start again. Mm-hmm. So we'll go ahead and we'll walk down this way, and I can show you where the corner of the property is.
Okay.
Make a right turn here.
This way?
Yes.
Krista, you want to walk on the other side?
So we can stop here.
Oh, stop here.
This is a good spot. So if you look down into that corner there, you can see a white stake. That's the actual corner of the property. And she referred to this section of the garden as the wild garden. She wasn't doing a lot of changing of what was here. So she, what you can see here a lot of are the lemonade berry. You look at the little tiny pink tips there. The Indians would actually collect those and make a sort of a lemon-scented tea. And when people would hike, you ran out of water, you were thirsty, you could rub that with your finger and taste it, and it would be kind of a very tart, lemony thing that would help your mouth regain its moisture.
Oh, wow.
The other native tree that you see a lot is the toyon. It's the taller one there, and as you look across the hillside, the large clumps of green are more likely to be either the lemonade berry or the toyon. When the Spaniards came to Monterey, they asked the Indians, what is that? And they said, we call it Toyon Toyoni. And the Spaniards shortened it to Toyon. And then when the English speakers came, they called it the California holly because it had red berries at Christmas time and kind of a scallopy edge to the leaf, similar to the holly that we think of in England.
Okay.
She planted cactus.
Opuntias there to start with. Opuntia is a very, very common coastal sage. And you can see that one little tiny pink reddish tip there, that would be the prickly pear that the Indians would have harvested as a fruit, and actually has a lot of vitamin C in it.
Hmm.
But that will just take off on its own. You can see the longer it's there, the more it develops kind of a barky protective area at the bottom.
Okay.
And this area is called Boat Canyon because where the water has the outlet to the sea is a sandy bottom. So it would be a place where you could have pulled up a small dinghy or a dory onto the shore without ripping it on the rocks.